Hello, everybody. Cheryl and I are here. We're going to take you through a strength and conditioning. We'll be here for, it's about 45 minutes without the cool down, I think, or just under. First section. So I'll tell you what we're going to do and what you need, and then you can go, then we'll get warmed up. Anyways, we're going to do a squat and press. So you're going to need a kettlebell or a dumbbell. So sitting back, pressing straight up. We're gonna do kettlebell swings, so you need probably the same kettlebell for that. You can do a kettlebell or a dumbbell for the next one. We're gonna do a reverse lunge. You're gonna stay down in that hold, so pick a side. So if your left leg is forward, you're gonna work your right arm. So you're gonna have a dumbbell or kettlebell, and we're gonna row. We're gonna stay down and just row. Then we're gonna switch sides. Then we're gonna do a hand-to-hand kettlebell swing, so switching out in front. Then we're gonna do a deadlift. So two hands on the kettlebell, so you'll need a heavier kettlebell or two dumbbells. And you're gonna come down and then come back up. We've got hamstring slider curls. So if you've got sliders, great. If not, grab a tea towel, dishcloth, anything like that if you've got a slippery floor. Otherwise, we're gonna do hip bridges, and Cheryl will be showing you that alternative. We've got suitcase squats. So you need something in each hand. You're gonna squat back and up. All right, then we've got skaters. So stay low, out to the side. You're shifting that weight over that outside leg. It's like a one-legged squat. So we've got 30 seconds on, 10 seconds of rest, three times through that. And then we'll get to the rest of it. I'm gonna get some music going. Maybe, maybe not. There we go. All right, so let's get warmed up. 10 jumping jacks to start. Get that heart rate up a little bit. Get the blood flowing. Once you've done 10, you've got 10 forward stepping lunges. We're warming up the hips, the knees, the ankles. You've got 10 in total. They don't have to be big. Just again, warming up all those areas. Once you've done 10, we've got leg swings. So 10 leg swings per side. If you need to help with your balance, you can hang onto a wall, the back of a chair. It helps to swing opposite arm to opposite leg. Keep that core nice and tight. Once you've done 10 on one side, you've got the other side. Eyes look straight ahead. Once you're done with the leg swings, come down, high plank position, same foot to same hand. Reach back for that rotation. Let the eyes follow that arm. Open up those hips. Open up the chest. Core stays tight. You've got 10 in total. Once you've done your 10, stay down. We've got plank jacks. So you've got 10 plank jacks. You can jump them out, you can step them out. Totally up to you. Once you've done your 10, up you come, grab some water, and we'll get started. All right, so goblet squat with a press. So pick your poison.
I'm just going to see what you're going to grab.
All right, so kettlebell up. 30 seconds on, 10 seconds of rest. In 3, 2, 1, here we go. Sit back into your heels. Lock that core on. At the bottom, squeeze the glutes. Keep the eyes looking straight ahead. Especially when you push up overhead. Don't look at it. That core tight. Sit back. We've got less than 10 seconds. In 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, kettlebell swings. I've got a kettlebell. Cheryl's going to show you with a dumbbell. All right, here we go. Push back into those heels. Keep those glutes nice and tight. Head and chest stay up tall. So we're pushing back, driving through those heels. squeezing the glutes. Eyes are looking straight ahead. We've got 5 seconds here. In 3, 2, 1. All right, reverse lunge with that row. So, pick a leg. If your left leg's forward, your right leg's back, you're rowing up. Yeah. So, you're just gonna stay down and hold that lunge. Row, core stays tight. That elbow comes up and back. Eyes are looking down at the floor. You're gonna feel that leg start to work. Drive through that front heel. And we're resting. Same thing, other side. So opposite leg back. Drop into that lunge. Drive that elbow up and back. Core's on tight. Hold that lunge. Driving through that front heel. We've got less than 10 seconds here. In 3, 2, 1. All right, hand-to-hand swings. So, if you're more comfortable starting with two hands or staying there, you can stay there. Otherwise, push back into those heels. Switch out front. Up. Drive into those heels. Squeeze those glutes. Core's on tight. Keep that head and chest up tall. You want that bum imprint in the wall behind you. Eyes are looking straight ahead. In 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, deadlifts. Kettlebell, 2 dumbbells, totally up to you. All right, here we go. Sit back in your heels, tip forward, keep those shoulder blades back, or shoulders back, sorry. It's like you're looking over a cliff. Eyes are down. About 2 to 3 feet in front of you on the floor. Drive into those heels. Think about looking over a cliff. You want to see, but you don't want to fall. And we're resting. Hamstring slider curls. So if you've got sliders, go ahead and grab them now. If you don't, just go into a hip bridge. So, on the sliders, you can do 1 leg out, 1 leg in. You can do 2 legs out, 1 leg in. 2 legs out, 2 legs in. No matter which version you're doing, keep those hips up tall. Bum is off the floor. Core is on tight. You're gonna feel those hamstrings work. And we're resting. Suitcase squats. So you need a weight in both hands. Here we go. Sit back in that imaginary chair. Drive into those heels. Squeeze the glutes. Head and chest stay tall. Eyes are forward. Sink into those heels. Drive them into the floor. Squeeze those glutes. In 3, 2, 1. All right, skaters. So, stay low, come side to side. It can be as big or as small. You can keep the 1 foot down, tap it back. As you switch, think about shifting your weight to that leg. It's like a one-legged squat. We've got 5 seconds here. 3, 2, 1. All right, we're back to the top. Squat and press. All right, sit back in that imaginary chair. Squeeze the glutes. Press up overhead. Core is on nice and tight. Eyes are straight ahead. Drive those heels. Push that bum back. All the way up. Keep breathing, keep moving. 3, 2, 1. Kettlebell swings. So two-handed swings. Here we go. Squeeze those glutes. Lock on that core. Head and chest stay up tall. Push those hips out behind you. Eyes are straight ahead. Squeeze those glutes. Fire up those legs. The arms are just the extension. And we're resting. We're back to that lunge with a hold with that rope. So pick a leg. We're gonna sit down in that lunge. Row it up. Lock that core on, it'll help with stability. Drive that elbow up and back. Nice flat back. Eyes are down on the floor. Awesome job. We've got just under 10 seconds here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Switching sides. All right. Opposite leg comes back. Down in that lunge. Row it up. Keep that back nice and flat. Slow and controlled with that row. Come up, feel that squeeze at the top. If you need to hold it, and then set it back down. Control it up, control it all the way down. We've got 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. All right, hand-to-hand swings. If you're uncomfortable with hand-to-hand, just stick with regular kettlebell swings. All right, sit back into your heels. Switch out front. We're squeezing those glutes. Every time we come up, eyes are straight ahead. That core, you know what I'm gonna say. Keep it on tight. Protect that low back. Sit into those heels. 3, 2, 1. All right, deadlifts. Two-handed deadlift. Push back into those heels. Keep those shoulders back. Eyes are looking down on the floor. About 2 to 3 feet in front of you. Awesome job. Feel those hamstrings work. Keep that weight back in the heels all the way down. Drive those heels to the floor all the way up. And we're resting. Hamstring slider curls or glute bridges. On the glute bridge, hips are up. Feet are very close to the bum. Just tap down, tap up. Sliders. Keep that bum off the ground, hips are up. Stay up on those shoulders. Keep breathing. All the way out, all the way in. Keep that core tight, pull that belly button into the spine. Nice strong center, and we're resting. Suitcase squats. So you need one in each hand. Sit back in that imaginary chair. Up we stand. Drive into those heels, squeeze the glutes as you stand up. Sit back. Drive all the way up. Head and chest stay up tall. Core is on tight. Protect that low back. 3 seconds, and we're resting. Skaters. So whatever option you want to do, stay low. Think of yourself like a speed skater. You want to stay nice and low. Keep that work in the legs. Come on. Find a focal point. It helps with your balance. Shift that weight to that leg. Make it work. We've got 5 seconds here. In 3, 2, 1. All right, one more time through. Back to that squat and press. All right, sit into that imaginary chair. Squeeze the glutes. Press up overhead. Drive into those heels. Sit all the way down. Press it all the way up. Just keep moving. They don't have to be fast. 10 seconds here. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, kettlebell swings are next. Here we go. Push back into those heels. Squeeze those glutes. Let the kettlebell come up to about the eyes. Make that bum imprint in the wall out behind you. Lock that core on. Protect that low back. Eyes are straight ahead. Head and chest are up nice and tall. Come on. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. All right. That reverse lunge hold with the rope. Grab your dumbbell. Step it back. You can do this without weight too. Hold that lunge and just make that rowing motion. Drive that elbow up and back. Keep a nice flat back. Eyes are down on the floor. Nice neutral head, neck, and spine. Weights in that front leg. Drive into that heel. And we're resting, switching sides. Opposite foot back, drop that back leg, up we row. Keep that core on tight, control that movement all the way up, all the way down. You can hold it for a little squeeze at the top, and right back down. Remember, eyes are on the floor, back is flat, weight is in that front heel. That front leg, drive that heel into the floor, and we're resting. Hand-to-hand swings. All right, last time with these hand-to-hand swings, here we go. So, drive into those heels, switch hands out front, squeeze those glutes as that kettlebell comes up to the eyes. Focus straight ahead. Head and chest stay tall. Lock your core on. Focus on pushing those hips up behind. In 3, 2, 1. Woo. All right, deadlifts. Two-handed deadlifts. All right. Weights back in your heels. Coming forward, keep those shoulder blades behind, holding back, squeeze those glutes. When the weight's at the bottom, squeeze those glutes, drive into the heels all the way up. Eyes are on the floor, 2 to 3 feet in front of you. Less than 10 seconds here, come on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo! All right. Hamstring slider curls or glute bridges. Hips up. If you're on sliders, slide them out, bring them back in. Keep
that core tight. Stay up on your shoulders. Keep that bum off the ground. Glute bridges. Your feet, your heels are close to your bum. You drive through those heels. Hold it up. Give it a squeeze. Tap it down. Go right back up. Either way, core is engaged. Core is tight. And we're resting. Suitcase squats.
Two dumbbells, two kettlebells, up to you. Here we go. Stand tall, sit into that imaginary chair. Squeeze those glutes at the bottom. Stand up nice and tall. Awesome job. We are almost through section one. It's two more. 10 seconds, come on. Next, we've got skaters. In three, two, one. All right, skaters. Then we're gonna take a little bit of a break while I explain section two. All right, here we go. Stay low, explode from side to side. You can keep that foot off the ground. You can tap it behind if you need it for balance. Pick a focal point. It helps you keep your balance. Shift that weight out over to that working leg. It's like a little one-legged squat every time. Three, two, one. All right, grab some water. Whew. Warmed up in here quick. All right, good news. The next one is only 25 seconds. I hope I have that one. My hands are cold. All right, so we're gonna move to upper body. So, we're gonna do a chest press from the floor. Two options. If you've got dumbbells, you can lay down. Dumbbells are right up over mid-chest. Your arms come out like goalposts. Just before touching the floor, and then they squeeze back up. You can also do this with a dumbbell, or sorry, a kettlebell. So again, starts mid-chest, you press straight up, and back down, straight up, back down. So you can do that. Then we've got chest flies. Again, arms are up, feet are flat on the floor. We keep them straight, they come out to the side, and then they squeeze back in. We've got push-ups from our knees or our toes. Then we've got rear delt flies. Sitting into your heels. Coming up, squeezing those delts, squeezing at the top, and coming back down. Then we've got a front side raise combo. So, two dumbbells. You're gonna come up in front, then you're gonna do a side raise. And just alternate back and forth. All right, 25 seconds on, 10 seconds of rest. We're gonna go through it four times. In three, two, one, here we go. So laying on your back, feet are flat on the floor. Remember, whether you're using dumbbells or kettlebells, it's mid-chest. Your arms are coming down like a goalpost. You want the small of your back to engage and touch the floor at all times. Pull that belly button into the spine at the bottom. And you're resting. We've got flies next. Same rules apply. Keep the small of the back engaged on the floor. Up we go. Arms are straight. They come straight out to the side. You're going to squeeze. Pull those shoulder blades apart all the way up to the top, because as you lower, shoulder blades come together. You're gonna squeeze. It's like you're squeezing through your armpits. All the way out, only go as low as you feel comfortable. Back up. And we're resting. Push-ups. Bring your knees and your toes. All right, here we go. Hands out wider than shoulders. Dropping your head between those shoulders. Keep
that core nice and tight. Keep that back flat. Again, only come down as low as you are comfortable. You can drop to your knees. Same premise applies. And we're resting on our feet. Rear delt fly. So you need two dumbbells. Here we go. Sit back into your heels. Knees are soft. Come up, squeeze those shoulder blades together. Arms come out at 9 and 3. Eyes are down on the floor. Keep that core on tight. In 3, 2, 1. All right, front side raises. Remember, we're alternating between the two. So we're gonna sit back in our heels. Knees are soft, come up to shoulder height, all the way down, and then again, come out into that T position. Eyes are straight ahead, core is nice and tight. We've got less than 10 seconds here. In 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, we're back to the top. Chest press. Dumbbells or kettlebells? All right. Feet on the floor. Keep that lower back nice and tight against the floor. Press up. Arms come out like goalposts if you've got dumbbells. Keep your feet engaged on the floor. Core nice and tight. Focus on shoulder blades coming apart. And then you let them relax. And we're resting. Flies. Feet are still flat on the floor. Arms are straight up. You're coming out to the side. Don't let them touch the floor. All the way back up. On the way down, shoulder blades are contracting together. You want to pull them apart on the way up. Awesome job. Squeeze all the way up. And we're resting. We've got push-ups. From your knees or your toes. All right, here we go. Nice flat back. Pull that belly button into the spine. Lower your head between your shoulders. Arms are out slightly wider than your shoulders. Come on, keep pushing. And we're resting. Rear delt flies. Grab your dumbbells. Sit into your heels. Keep those knees soft. Come up to 9 and 3 with the arms. Nice flat back. Eyes are down on the floor. Keep that core engaged. Come on. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Front side raise combination. Alright. Again, sit into your heels. Keep those knees soft. Come up in front. Then come out into that T position out at the sides. All the way up and down. Don't worry about your speed. Keep that core nice and tight. Stay back in your heels. It'll protect your low back. And we're resting. All right, back to the top, round 3. Halfway through this round. Chest press. Dumbbells or kettlebell are at mid-chest. Arms come down like goalposts. They lightly tap the floor and you squeeze back up. Feet are flat on the floor. Pull that belly button into the spine. Keep the small of your back on the floor. Don't let it come up. Push it down. And we're resting. We've got flies. So again, Arms are straight up. We're coming straight out to the side. Here we go. Come out to the side. Squeeze to bring those kettlebells or dumbbells back up to the top. Again, feet are flat on the floor. Pull that belly button into the spine. Push the small of the back down as you squeeze back up. All the way out, all the way up. And we're resting. Push-ups are next. From your knees or your toes. Hands out. Here we go. Lowering that body between the arms. Eyes are down on the floor. Back is nice and flat. That belly button, you pull it up into your spine. You want a nice strong center. Awesome job. And we're resting. All right, rear delt flies. Here we go, sit back into your heels. Squeeze all the way up. Bring it back down. Control. So try not to use momentum to fling them up. And then again, exercise control on your way down. Use the muscle on the way up and on the way down. In four, three, two, one. All right, front side raises. Whew. All right, here we go. Sit back into those heels. Knees are soft. Raise it up in front and then out to the side. All the way up, all the way down again. Don't let gravity take over. Control it up, control it down. If you're finding that you're having to throw it up and arch your back, drop down and wait. All right, one round to go. We're back to chest press. Here we go. Dumbbells up. Arms come out like goalposts. Squeeze back up. Let the shoulder blades come together on the way down. Pull them apart as you push the dumbbells back up top. Keep the small of the back on the floor. Pull that belly button into the spine. Keep your feet on the floor. And we're resting. Chest flies are next. Here we go, arms up. Out to the side, shoulder blades squeeze together. You're gonna pull them apart on the way back up. Again, drive that small of the back on into the floor. Pull that belly button into the spine. All the way out, all the way in. And we're resting. All right, push-ups from your knees and your toes. Drop that chest. I just had to question, place your ground rod. That's going to make us do another one. Belly buttons into the spine. Nice, strong center. Long, nice, long body. Come on. Last round of push-ups. And we're resting. Rear delt flies.
Meeny, meeny, miny,
mo. I know. All right, sit back into your heels. Keep those knees soft. Back's nice and flat. Eyes are down on the floor. Arms are coming up at 9 and 3. That's roughly where you're aiming for. Keep that core tight. In 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, last one in this section. Front side raises. Sounds like I don't know what I'm wanting to do. Sit back in your heels, knees are soft. Up. You're alternating between a double front raise and a double side raise. If you've got issues with your lower back or it's starting to hurt, you can pull yourself into a kickstand position like Cheryl's doing. That back leg helps offset the pressure in your low back. And we're resting. Woo! Grab some water. One round to go. Okay, final section, it's all core. I know, everyone's favorite. We've got four exercises. We're gonna go three rounds at the exercise and then be done with it. True Tabata, so 20 seconds on, 10 seconds of rest, three times. Good. Yep. So we start with V-sits. So you can do both arms and legs up at once, one arm, one leg, or come up and give your knees a nice hug. Woo! All right, three, two, one, here we go. Focus on using that core to pull the shoulder blades and the legs up. Pull that belly button into the spine. Focus on controlling up and all the way down. And we're resting. We're gonna stay with V-sits. Here we go. Again, you can do one arm, one leg. You can do both at the same time. You can also come up, give the knees a nice little hug, and come back out. Regardless, you're pulling your belly button into your spine. You're focused on that core. And we're resting one more time. We want to work that core all the way up, all the way down. All right, here we go. Last round of V-sits. Feel that core work. Feel it bring your shoulders up, bring your legs up, and then use that core to help set them back down. Take gravity out of the mix. We don't want to be like flopping fish. Control. And we're resting. All right. Next one, you'll need a dumbbell or a kettlebell. Weighted sit up. Straight up, keep the arms straight up. You're gonna sit yourself all the way up. Again, control it on the way down. All right, three, two, one, here we go. So you can keep your legs straight, you can keep your legs bent. Sit yourself all the way up, use that core. Control up. Control all the way down. Awesome job. And we're resting. Round one of three. It's nice to just not have to think about that exercise anymore. All right, arms up, here we go. Roll it all the way up. Come all the way down to the floor. Focus on that core. Make it work. Take momentum out of it. Going, and we're resting. One more time. All right, last time with these weighted sit-ups. All the way up. Curl down one vertebrae at a time. Set yourself down. Sit all the way up. Focus on that core. Make it work. In three, two, one. All right, we've got plank with a body saw. So you can rock yourself forward and back. You don't have to though. If you're more, all right, here we go. You can just hang out here in the plank, or you can rock forward and back. Pull that belly button into the spine. Keep the bum down, back nice and flat. We've got 5 seconds here. And we're resting. One down, two to go. All right, here we go. Again, there's nothing wrong with just holding the plank. Pull that belly button into the spine. You You rock forward onto your toes, and then push back. You don't have to be quick. In 3, 2, 1. One more round. Then we have one more exercise, then we are done. Whew. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Back is flat. Bum is down. Rocking forward and back. You need to take a little break. You can go right back into it. And we're resting. Whew. All right. Final exercise is a dead bug. So, 2 weights, or you can do this body weight. Opposite arm, opposite leg. So legs are up at 90 degrees. Here, opposite arm, opposite leg extend. So you can do a body weight like I'm doing here. All right. Let's see. In 3, 2, 1, here we go. Don't overthink it. Again, pull the belly button into the spine. Opposite arm, opposite leg. All the way back. If the weight is too much, drop the weight and just go body weight. And we're resting. One down, two to go. Whew. Back up, opposite arm, opposite leg. Draw that belly button into the spine. Only go back as far as you're comfortable with your shoulder. Don't have to go all the way back. Again, body weight is perfectly fine too. And we're resting. One more time. 20 seconds, that's all I need. All right, legs up. Here we go, final round, opposite arm, opposite leg. Feel that core engage. Pull that belly button into your spine. Control the arm and leg out. Bring it back in. Awesome job. And we're resting, we are done. Whew. All right, awesome, awesome job today. Thank you so much for joining us.